I've never gotten stuck like that.
What was that about?
I couldn't... I don't know. Do you want to try?
What was that about?
Last question. I think I got stuck and it was very confusing.
Oh, and you were confused, were you?
But he's really drunk right now.
Do you like your new gift?
The lion is... I awoke to it on my face.
Oh.
Which is something different. Do you want to come with me to the flower shop? Maybe.
Yes.
Yeah. Then let's go. I think I'm traumatized now. That was pretty bad. Hello, Gloria. Looking
good
lovely
evening.
As ever.
How are you doing today?
Oh, quite well.
Fucking growling at each other.
Going to shop and not.
Yes, right. Starts 3:45 in the morning. It's fine. Server came up. What do you want from me? A lot of alcohol to finish. Evening, Astrid.
Some work here, but it's locked, so I can't get some that. Hello.
Good evening, Dr. Alva. Uncle?
Oh yeah, is that you? What are you wearing?
Wow! Okay, I'm sorry. No. I didn't lift my hair up. I'm sorry.
No, it's really fine. I just wanted to show around the parade to the hospital.
Mm. Hospital's got an extension.
Mm-hmm.
You have twice, if not three times, the room now.
Listen, I took that class once to find out where everything was. I'm not taking it again.
Shouldn't need to. That's a back area to the morgue there.
Holy hell. Wow, this is a lot bigger than I remember.
Much bigger. It's quite nice. Hello, Kosh. Hello, Mr. Shlomo. I'm showing them around the hospital.
There you go, Kosh.
Look, more room for bodies.
Well, I need to give you those, the money. How much do I need?
Don't worry about it. I just saw a sign saying you needed tea, so I'm giving you tea.
Oh my god, there's actual spots for bodies, not just HELP!
That
door doesn't open, but the other one does.
Okay. That's weird.
It's fine.
We just take a
They locked
way,
inside
right?
somewhere? Where they locked?
We're stuck.
That's fine.
Side, I don't know why. There's a recovery ward this way.
Well, I can't see where you are, so I'm just moving extremely slowly.
Marco?
Oh no.
Gosh.
Yes.
No.
You come here.
No.
But I...
No. You are.
Bang on that door right there. I think it's locked.
That's yes.
It's fine.
Yes,
it's
Shlomo.
It's...
Yes, Shlomo. We were banging on the door. It's because it's locked. Do you think it's locked? Do you think it might be locked?
You owe me money for tea, Gloria.
I don't owe you shit.
Yes, you owe me money for tea.
Oh no. Definitely never covered for anything you've fucking done. So I'm going to definitely give one cup of tea to some stranger that's had a very bad day and you're like, listen, do you need money for tea? How much does your tea cost?
Offices upstairs.
Typically two copper, but you have to pay an inflation of 500%.
How about this? I'll pay you a glass and you could just deal with it.
No.
No.
I only take payments from you in funny jokes, so I need one joke from you.
Your face.
You mean how much?
That was just hurtful.
Where'd it go? You were just standing there. Where the fuck did he go? He was literally right here, then he just fucked off.
Good. Your joke was so good, it made him die.
Yes, it did.
The recovery ward, emergency ward, and surgery ward got upgrades. And upstairs are just
offices?
Curious to what else got upgraded now.
I don't know. I just did Shlomo come back because everything's moving in such a weird way, I have no idea where he went.
Not that I see. He might have ran off.
I thought I heard him, but I wasn't sure if he took a nap or if he actually ran off.
This balcony here.
Oh my god, this balcony's gorgeous.
I can't open that door, unfortunately.
Doctors and Daria, Dr. Tanith.
Yep.
It's a gorgeous hospital. Dr. Lacroix. Look, he actually works here now.
Buzz. And what's this? A surgery ward.
Look at this laboratory.
How are you doing?
Absolutely breathtaking. And I love it.
It's quite nice.
So much more spacious. I'm so happy.
It's probably far enough away from the other side that it's not too big for you, right?
Probably.
Recovery ward. Look at these. These are so nice. These are nice. Mm-hmm. But listen, I still have to have chains in my office. What the hell?
Chains?
Did you never notice the chains in the walls in the security office?
Did yours get the upgrade or not?
I don't know. I haven't been that far.
I don't know yet.
Did you want to go check security?
Honestly, I don't even know if we can get in there.
Why wouldn't we be able to get in there?
You know, certain doors are shut.
No, they're not.
No.
If I get locked out of the fucking office, I'm going to be furious.
Take a look in the box.
Town is so busy.
Wow,
oh,
my head fucking hurts.
I really doubt we had any changes. I didn't think we needed any changes, honestly.
Maybe a way to lock the door.
I don't want it locked.
Definitely.
We need to put in an order for a table. The table's there, you just can't see it. No, they did. What they did to the door is auto closes off now. So the door will just straight up stay open.
Oh no.
It'll stay open or stay closed, yep.
Okay.
So it's open if there's no one in here. Look at that, what a concept. And I just need a casual sign that says knock if the door's closed. Duh.
Alright. The best thing you could do, probably.
Yep.
Sort of.
The hospital got a completely revamp and we lost the bathrooms! I'm so sad.
The bathroom?
The bathrooms that were on the other side?
The hell? There's the bathroom inside of the hospital.
What the fuck is happening in here?
We were just we were looking around. Why?
All I heard was something about a bathroom.
We lost the bathrooms, alright? That's all.
There's a bathroom in the hospital. There's a latrine and a bathroom.
Alright, I'm just going on an adventure. We were just looking to see if the security office changed at all, which it has not, except for the fact that the door doesn't automatically close anymore, which is great, because people can't walk in. The door is open. No one's there. If it's closed, people are there. We're fine. Goodbye. He's mad because I didn't pay him for a cup of tea. I should probably pay him. I don't know what I should pay him, though.
Nothing.
I mean, I did take some tea from his shop.
Did he give it to you willingly?
No, he wasn't there. I reached over the counter, grabbed it, and gave it to some new person. Because they were exhausted.
Do you want some tea?
No, I didn't want any tea. They did.
Okay.
Hello, Miss Adelaide. You're looking ravishing today.
Hello. I'm upset, Spaghetti.
Why?
Because all of the books are gone.
No, they're not. They're not. They're not. They're not. They're not. They're not. The world apparently just confused a certain individual.
They're gone.
Are
the
they?
The ones in the center are gone.
Mm. Are they?
They're gone.
Oh,
unless
no.
My brain is confused because of this confused...
Those flowers are so beautiful.
Being over here.
I feel like you're menacing me with a bouquet of flowers, and I don't know if I deserve this.
I'm gonna
deserve the flowers or don't deserve the menacing?
Either, honestly. I just woke up. I don't deserve any of this. Would you like a drink instead?
Oh, thank you, drink.
It's a nice glass.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they're gone. They're.
See, but I have my notes. They're
fucking gone.
Maybe the books are just gone.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's a very nice flowers. Hello, Count Diego. Goodbye, Count Diego.
All the books in there are gone.
I'm so sorry. Why do you think I do the books the way I do the books?
I mean, those aren't as bad because you have them in a way to where I can just write them back down. It's the other ones that I had. And,
there's a reason why I always record in old files first.
I need to go check the library. Oh, shit.
Like I said, anything that I wrote, I have. Mr. Lord Grey is back with the menacing flowers. He was gone and now he has returned. They're very nice flowers.
They're my flowers. You can't have them.
I feel like...
Quite Lord, lovely.
Lord Grey, I think you need to learn how to relax when you're holding something like that. Because right now, you really just look like you want to hurt somebody with them.
Well, because if I don't think I'm holding them still.
You're not anymore, but...
Well, see, I could smack you with the flowers.
Mm-hmm.
Won't hurt you at all.
I don't know. Go for it. No, we don't have a uniform.
No, they won't hurt you. Now, where the hell is Verona gone?
I would assume the flower shop.
Well, she wasn't there. She's now she's not.
We should probably reschedule that meeting tomorrow. Listen, we hired the maestro to make the constabulary uniforms. She keeps making cowboy outfits.
Well, anything's better than whatever Marcellus is wearing. No offense, Marcellus. Wow. You need some color.
Listen, I'll make a point that our family is not necessarily known for style.
Our family?
Do not start that again. It is 2 o'clock in the morning, I have been drinking, just... and I am going to dunk you in the fountain if you start that again.
I mean, I didn't start it.
Listen, yeah. I am going to dunk you both in the fountain if you start it again.
It's that, I don't know what you're speaking about.
Listen.
It's fine. Nothing happened.
We all need a drink.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I thought the colors of the house were black and red, and then you said they were what, green and gold?
Green,
I don't think
green,
any of
black,
us have a fucking idea
gold,
what the goddamn colors are.
Put on some color, please, Marcella.
I don't want color, I like gold and white.
Only reason I'm wearing white is because it's a medical outfit, that's all.
What in the hell are you doing?
I got my cup. I'm ready.
The Sonic meet. Then the Sonic. The science meeting. I need to talk to someone from the science club. Got some blood samples. There's supposed to be some sort of meeting about that, right?
It's supposed to be on Friday, but you know.
Nasty storm.
I was warned about the storm. I ignored everybody's warning about the storm. It's fine.
Why'd you ignore everyone's warnings about the storm?
I hear him, but I don't see him.
Right
here. Where? No, I don't see him at all. There's no one there.
Yeah, I don't see. I hear voices and I don't see anyone.
Yep. Nope. This is the way of it, I guess. Yep, now he's there.
Okay then.
Drifting. I wasn't ignoring you. I literally the world was catching up with you, alright? As he walks away dramatically.
I wasn't questioning things. And how are
again.
You, Marcellus?
If I could see you, great.
Listen, I'm pretty sure. Everyone's drunk. That's what's happening
probably.
Here. 100%, 1,000,000%, everyone is drunk.
I don't think the doctor's drunk.
I think she should be.
Probably could. She doesn't just, you know, things happen. Probably don't want a drunk doctor.
Maybe I want a drunk doctor.
Sure. That sounds fun.
Right. Why is there no bar in the... Hey, he's back! Why is there no bar in this town?
I thought there was a bar in town.
No, you're a tea shop, I thought.
No, I said I thought there was a bar in the town.
No, there's a winery, but I wouldn't call that a bar.
Oh, I thought it was a bar, because I know they sold the harder alcohols, too.
No. I have no idea what's happening, honestly. Kasia has just gone all the way down the street and gone. She's straight up gone.
Weird. I don't know, maybe I should turn mine into a bar. No one comes in for the tea anyways, they only come in for the books.
Listen, you are like the prime example of a smut shop. But it's good smut, right? I don't know.
I don't have any smut.
Novels.
There is no hanky panky in any of my books.
It's all like soft cover novels and romance.
Those were put in by request.
I'm just saying that I'm sure the spines are well loved on all of those books broken in.
Hey, you've seen that I can make other things than romance books, but you hated it.
Yes, I did. But listen, I hated when you wrote things that were romantic, too.
Okay. What genre would you prefer?
Adventure. Mystery. Murder.
Tragedy.
Tragedy, yes.
Okay, I gave her a book on tragedy and she hated it.
No, you gave me a biography. You didn't give me a book, you gave me a biography. I swear I was reading this man's tombstone.
It was perfectly well written, thank you.
I wasn't saying it wasn't well written, it was boring though. It was then and then and then. There was no plot or build up or follow through or adventure or like conclusion. It was just and then everybody died.
Those are some of the best stories when everyone
listen,
dies.
No. See, you could have told this as a really good story, but you would have to tell it from already after everybody has died and as a ghost story, and then you have to go and kind of explore these things as a ghost story. If you told it as a ghost story, it would be glorious. But no, you told it from start to finish in the tragedy of the art, and it was like, there's no build-up.
You know, I was thinking about making a story about the plague, where a family gets infected and slowly, one by one, they just kind of drop. What do you think?
No. You're horrid.
What do you mean I'm horrid?
If you're not writing things to torment people, you're writing people to bore them to death.
It's not tormented. The last survivor will be the young child, who will slowly starve to death because no one can feed him.
That's horrid.
I don't think you just understand good literature.
I think you don't understand what literature is, and what you're writing is literally just sad biographies. I'm sure we could have picked a better place to stand, but I'm afraid to move right now. You're just saying that, it's fine.
Also, where'd your uncle disappear to?
He's changing his clothes. Leave him alone. Unlike you, who just runs off into oblivion, changes his clothes, and comes back like nothing happened.
What do you mean, runs off? I ran to the tea shop.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you did.
It's good to see you back in your typical clothing, Gloria.
Thank you, I suppose.
It's just bizarre seeing you in anything else.
Is it the colors or the fabrics? Look, I even put a skirt on so it looks formal and pretty.
No, you wouldn't know my honest opinion when you're not wearing heavy armor. I'm thinking you're wanting to wear the light fabric so you can move quicker to quickly assassinate somebody.
I don't think I would do assassinations very well.
No, a bit clunky, but still. I don't know, I just never trusted somebody when I always see them in something heavy and they're all of a sudden just wearing something very light and they can move quickly in it. It always weirds me out.
Oh, you don't like when I wear black head to toe and skin-tight clothes?
No, not really. It doesn't suit you.
Finally, you've got the good pants on.
What'd you say, Kasha?
What? Nothing. I am done.
Excited to finally get out of the house. You know, I was trapped in the penthouse for the storm. I was losing my mind from boredom.
But I've been trapped inside of your room at the manor, but you know, you never go back there anymore, so.
I do go back there, and when I get back there, there's no one there!
Marcellus. I have to say, that is actually a stunning outfit. You look good in it. Much better than the armor.
really want to hurt you so bad right now.
What did I do?
You know what you did.
No, I don't.
Oh, yes you do.
If I knew, I wouldn't be asking.
Oh, you know what you did.
No, I really don't know what I did.
I'm going to go back home. I'll see you later.
Be safe.
To see right. You first, first.
You as well.
I mean, I've literally been asleep for a few days, and I think I was even asleep day or two before the storm came, so I literally have no idea what I could have done.
You just think long and hard about some of those decisions you made.
I did, and...
Not you!
I want to think long and hard about the things
you said. I mean, I don't think I've actually done anything that actually hurt anybody.
I'll speak to you privately later.
Will you?
I mean, if Gloria will just let us use her office.
Have a good time, my son.
You can use my office if you fucking knock. If the door is closed, there's someone in it.
Sounds like a good time. Bye.
Okay, come on.
What?
Where's he going?
I don't know.
Wait, are we using the office or?
Yes, the office.
I didn't understand what's happening.
I don't either. The world is angry.
You're walking towards the horses.
I'm gonna go towards the office.
I think the world's just angry at us or something.
Evening. I don't know. He's a fat boy, okay? I don't question the fats.
You did feed him, right?
I fed him, yeah. So he's a liar! I'll be right back.
Are you the fat? Are you the fat?
Gloria, can you hear me by chance?
These people don't even have names anymore. I just live
Hello,
here.
Hello, Gloria.
I don't know what's happening.
Hold still, I'll get you out of the chair.
No, I thought I was out of the chair. I don't even know where anyone is. I don't know what's happening. Is it bad for you too? Oh, my God. I was in the campfire.
You were actually stuck in the chair. No, you were stuck in the chair just running in place for a second.
We were in the office. Now we're both invisible.
Well, right. Apparently whenever he said he wanted to talk, privately, he was apparently talking to Kosh. Holy shit, you're back in the chair.
Life is not an easy thing for me at the moment. I'm just gonna live here. Now I'm in the office with you again. Why are we in the office? How did you get me? I was at the campfire. How are we in the office?
We're not in the office.
We're in the office!
By the campfire.
Nope, we're in the office.
Okay, you know what? I'm going to attempt to see what happened if we just use the caravan.
Oh my God, I'm going to die. Oh God.
I'm probably going to die.
I'm God. Wait, can you hear me? As I know, bro, she's dead then, and I'll be live. I'll be in bed. Spread eagle variant, ladylike. Listen, it's fine.
I'm going to apologize if this goes south quick.
I'm ready to enter the void, Shlomo. I'm ready. This
Let's
is how
enter
I die.
The void.
Together.
Let's enter the void together. Together.
So Edward's in the office with us. I don't want to die. I don't know what's happening. I don't know if the world's upset, or if I'm upset, or something else. I'm here now. Well, how are we at the beginning of Murky Stone? Did we?
I took you to the South Jungle back here and I put you down.
I think that.
We're in Murky Stone where you tend to get off the caravan.
Nope, I understand that. I'm just living my life. I'm wondering if it would be better to take a nap or what.
I can't see.
I'm in the chair!
Oh. was this a thing?
I don't know!
Okay. Okay. I'm willing to try this again.
I'm not. I'm just gonna live here. It's fine.
Oh, do you know what your uncle's angry at me about?
No fucking clue. Could be anything.
To somewhere else.
Listen, it could be because you tried to kill him, it could be because you lied, it could be because I didn't know you were flirting with somebody you liked. I don't fucking know. It's green now.
Okay, you can see things now.
No, I can't. I'm currently at the beginning of Murky Stone, struggling to exist. You've drifted away from me.
I'm still carrying you.
I understand. I'm just in your arms at the beginning of Murky Stone forever.
You know, let's just wait
here. We're in the jungle!
Yes, we're in the jungle.
What? What the fuck is happening? I don't like it.
Okay, you want to just stand perfectly still and
I'm not moving.
You don't die.
I'm in your arms as you're licking a rock. Now you're sitting. What are you sitting on?
I am sitting on the ground.
No, we are just licking a rock.
Oh, well, I'm actually on top of the rock overlooking the caravan right now.
No, we are licking a rock.
I mean, this I can rock. Move if it helps.
No, I don't think it'll help, because right now, you and that rock, very intimate, and I'm in between you and the rock, and I was not looking for this kind of a threesome.
What can I say? I just love me a good rock.
Just love you a good hot place.
Yes, I do. Oh. I've actually been wanting to... You know, it's actually a good thing I have you here. I've been wanting to say something to you for some time now.
Oh, God.
What do you think I'm going
to
say?
I don't know. It cannot possibly be a good thing. No one ever tells me good things and they want to talk to me.
Actually, I want to say I know I've been actually a royal pain in the ass as of late, and I'm sorry.
Well, you only get away with it because somehow I consider you a friend, which is somehow, like, which is species trait of bullshit nonsense, but, you know.
Like I said, I'm just wanting to say I'm sorry. I've been a bit of an asshole as of late.
It's alright. I'm not known for my kindness either, so the shit lords must stay together.
I wanted to say sorry if any of my comments have come across off as mean or rude.
They all come across as mean and rude. As long as you understand that I'm going to return them right back to you, return to sender.
Of course. I just know that sometimes my jokes don't come across as jokes. They come across as just mean.
Ah, well.
I mean, you might not know this about me, but I don't always think shit through before I do things.
I think that's about 90% of the time you don't think shit through before you do things.
Yeah, see, it's like you know me a little bit.
It's unfortunate, really. Are you actually moving right now?
I am standing completely still, Gloria.
Oh, look, we're at the top of the rock now. Glorious. Where's the caravan?
I will say, if you have any kind of questions about my recent behavior activities, now's probably the best time to get it out of me.
Yep, because no one's going to find anything. So, okay, which of the White Wolf sightings are you, by the way?
Okay, the sighting involving the two women here in the jungle were me and Robert. We weren't actually trying to hurt them, and he did try scaring them off by getting close.
Mm-hmm.
But we hurt nobody. Oh, and I might have been spotted killing skeletons in the north.
Alright, because there was two wolves in the north and two wolves here, and I'm like, that's got to be you and Robert every time.
No, just Robert and me once only. I don't know about the other times.
Then the two in the Highlands isn't you.
No, I'm sorry.
Well, that's alright.
But I will say it's very possible that it could have been Robert and Ray.
I mean, the thought crossed my mind, but I don't know. Perhaps not safe to assume, but
There's a reason why they wanted me to do the autopsy or look over.
I don't know if that's quite it, or if they just needed the body back. But fuck.
No, not to be disrespectful, but a lot of Lycans don't want, well, one of your kind touching our corpses.
To be fair, we don't really like you either, so feelings mutual, darling.
Yeah, right, it's kind of an old hatred for us. Did you hear what our creation legend is?
Something about a worm? I don't know.
I'll give you the short. Essentially, vampires and undead came into the world, and nature created us as a natural counter. That's the quick version.
You know, in our legend, you existed in the land of Nord before we did. You were things naught of Adam and Eve. You know, we're children of Cain. Humans are children of Seth. You are not children of anything. But the monsters in the dark, moon beasts.
Indeed. So what, we're some kind of enigma?
Our scriptures don't talk about you very much, except to say stay the fuck away from them and don't feed on them.
No, we're very toxic to each other.
Of the moon beasts. The moon beasts, the ones who change. They are the oldest of all. Before my father, they roam the lands. Tarry not in the path of them. Avoid them. They are set upon us like wolves in the sheepfold. For we are one kind and they another. Beware their sacred ground. Walk softly through their wilderness. Their bite as our bite. Their claws as our claws. Tarry not in the path of them. They are one kind and we are another. That's about as extensive as it gets. I think there's something in some other chronicle somewhere that I don't know, and I kind of avoid all the Gehenna talk that talks of you, but I don't know. And then there's a commandment: feed not on the moon beast, the enlightened, the insane, and the drunkards.
Yeah, I've seen vampires feed on my people before, with mixed results. I watched a key feeder feed on one before, and he went insane. So I thought that might just been him.
What's a key feeder?
Yeah. You don't know what key is?
No, darling, I don't know what key is.
There's a type of vampire from the Orient that feeds on a certain form of energy from the human body. And they call this energy key, like QI or something like that.
Hmm.
Until I saw one, I thought they were fucking lies. Because apparently you defeat this vampire by taking his sock and throwing it into a river.
Probably a malform.
Probably. Personally, I think that's just misdirection on how to take care of him. And if that's honestly how to take care of him, I'm going to either cry or laugh.
I have never met these. Like I said, it's probably a malform. A malformed embrace.
Any other questions of me?
Tell me about the ones that aren't born but made.
Oh, the beasts, yes. They're more feral and they don't have the higher intellect when they turn. At least they're not supposed to. Ones that are born can change at will. Ones that are made can only really turn during moonlight.
And typically
the ones that... Well, yes and no. Depends on who you ask. Some lichens claim to have a cure. Others say it's not real. Typically, a pure blood will have no real respect of a changed one's leadership. They simply won't support it. They're considered lesser.
Sit down. If we're going to sit here and talk, sit down at least. I mean, it'll take me 10 minutes to realize you've done it, but...
Well, it might take me a minute to sit down. Okay, I'm sitting down.
Now we'll see how long until I recognize you sitting down. That truly does sound like a curse.
What, getting turned?
Losing control of yourself every time the moon comes out.
Yes, it's the downfall of getting turned over being born. Unless you, are lucky to find a proper sire, it's something that's unavoidable. With lots of time, training, and concentration, you can learn to have more self-control. Otherwise, you simply don't.
Sounds horrid.
I guess it's the equivalent of your fledglings.
Yes, but our fledglings are expected to come out of that, and they do.
Well, the benefit is, when they give birth to their children, they will have self-control. Typically, it's only really done if you've suffered massive casualties or some kind of reason why you no longer have the population you did. Be it migration, disease, war. A very bloody peck challenge.
Do a lot of your peck challenges end in death?
Typically they do.
You have to do something truly terrible to end up with a blood hunt called on you.
It can be bad. But if someone's allowed to live after the challenge is done, depending on the pack, you can be considered rather shameful. You're too cowardly to die from your own challenge. And some packs won't even allow challenges. It's hereditary.
I don't
know. Oh, and you'll find most packs don't actually get along with each other.
I don't know. Most of the ones of your kind that I know tend to be solitary. Or actively trying to be solitary and then dragged into whatever the fuck is happening in Silverfang. The Silverfang's secret. The thing that happens in the dark. Ugh.
So a lot of my kind live in Silverfang, then?
I don't know if a lot of them live in the Silverfang. I know that at least a few.
Beta wolves.
Perhaps. I honestly don't know how many of them are, but I know they know of at least one or two. And they like to keep it a big secret. So, what the fuck that means. Seems like a bunch of humans protecting one or two wolves. So okay, I'm going to keep casting as some fucking wizard or something if anyone asks me. Hey, we're on the ground now. I'm on the ground now. I hate it. Oh. I'm gonna quit and restart. Because I think this is me. I'm going back to the chair of doom. Fair. Hey! You! What are you doing? Gimme butt! Give me that puppy butt! Tonka! It's a puppy butt! Hi! Don't you run from me! Maybe the world... Maybe it will be better. I'm very drunk. Maybe it will be better now that we're
chair.
Maybe it will be better now.
Indeed.
Right, sit. Let me see how long it takes for me to see you sit. Oh my god, it was almost instant.
That was shockingly quick. And you're freely moving around. Congratulations.
Yeah. It's crazy. Oh my god. It's a fucking miracle.
Indeed. All it took was a local that hit me in the head with a rock.
Come here. He's fucking fighting. Come here.
So, did you have any other questions about or my activities? Okay.
What the fuck have you been doing this whole time? And then colliding with a kindred?
What have I been doing? I've basically been spending my time with Zeloria pretty much here in the jungle. I've been making sure not to piss anybody off to the best of my abilities. Which was... Well, I was actually surprised that your uncle is upset with me about something new.
Fuck if I know. Everything is always, always, always a mess.
I honestly haven't been doing anything. This time. I'll admit, yes, I kicked him off the roof. But he said we were fine, because we had an arrangement. Unless there's something new, I'm lost.
I don't know. Maybe there's something new. I don't know. Everybody's been stuck inside. They've probably been contemplating all the horrible things for hours and hours and hours on end.
Well, I couldn't do horrible things even if I wanted to. I was told I'm not allowed anymore.
He told you you're not allowed to do horrible things anymore.
My fiancé, of course.
I suppose. Goodness.
Well, I'm not about to do anything to risk her, so I've been trying to keep my nose clean.
Well, I hope that's true. Listen, the whole... cult nonsense is scary enough. Let alone I keep waiting for the rather red eye to drop.
The other red eye.
You cannot imagine that he's going to just let it go.
I don't know. He does seem like the type. He gave his word.
Well... maybe.
I mean, he was gonna do. What am I? That is not a question to ask me. That's a question to ask Zeloria.
Tomorrow, then.
Whenever she says. She told me two things: never fuck with a woman's birthday or her wedding. So I am not picking the date that will be her.
Maybe she wants you to pick the date.
Well, I've tried suggesting locations that didn't work out too good for me. I've tried suggesting other things that didn't work out too good for me. I am happy to let her pick whatever she likes.
Maybe she's just keeping you on a short leash.
Oh,
dog jokes!
You say that, but have you seen me? Have you seen me without a short leash? I require it, madam.
Yes, I think you do, in fact, require a short leash.
I don't know. If she's wakes up and isn't having any issues, knowing her, she'll probably want to get it done sooner than later before I can find a way to get myself into trouble.
Yes, probably. You know, maybe that's the way around the whole commandment about moonbeasts. The way we treat those who serve is substantially different than those, than others. They are the only ones who are not kindred that we have any iota of care for.
Well, how so? I can't imagine there'd be a great deal of care for us.
No, everything in all of the books always says just avoid them. But I guess, no, those who serve are specifically the children of Seth. And I'm trying to come up with any fucking justification that might get around the fucking commandments of it. Because it is expressly forbidden, you know.
Not everybody goes by those commandments of yours.
True, and not everybody is religious, but not everybody met God when they fucking died, so.
I mean, to be fair, whenever you were talking about the masquerade weeks and weeks ago, people didn't know the hell you were talking about half the time.
Oh no, the fucking Fledderlings didn't know what I was talking about. All the fucking Andalusian and the Elders did.
Well, yes, the Elders, but a lot of other ones didn't.
That's the problem, it's all fucking Fledglings. Fledglings and neonates who are never educated, so of course they wouldn't know what I'm fucking talking about.
Speaking of the masquerade, I haven't heard anything about Jesse in a while.
That is because Jesse is a citizen of Grimwood, did you know? So am I.
You're fucking kidding me. The guy who threw a big ass fit and more or less stormed off is literally went crawling back to Grimwood.
No, so he has agreed to appear to the masquerade, as have all of the archivists. As of all, that is part of the contract of Grimwood now. There's two parts. There's, you know, serve and recall and, you know, standard, like, I'm a citizen, these are my duties things, and then there's the kindred's agreement, which is basically the acceptance of the traditions, the adherence of the masquerade, so on and so forth.
I see.
He's chosen to uphold it on behalf of, because of the fledglings. Because I don't know what the fuck happened, but we have an ungodly fucking quantity of them.
Yeah, reasons like that, that's why I don't turn people anymore.
I'd have never turned anyone.
I've turned one, and it did not end well for me.
I don't think I'd want to. I cannot imagine a scenario where I would desire to. I keep no servitors. I don't keep anyone particularly close outside of the kindred, and even inside of the kindred, they're not particularly close. I cannot fathom why.
There was a lovely young woman once, centuries ago. her sire attempted to turn her. He couldn't seem to finish the job, so she was stuck in this horrible position where lichen venom was in her body, but it was so impotent it couldn't finish the job, so she was just in constant agony. So I had to finish the job. And I don't know if it was the influence from the first or she herself was so chaotic. I had to end her life myself. The daughter I mentioned I had to kill before. I wouldn't recommend siring anybody unless you were absolutely sure it's someone you wish to sire. And don't do it out of pity like I have.
Yeah, that's how you get, that's how you get very fucking lost fledglings. If you save someone from emergency, it better be someone you fucking care about. Otherwise, it should be done with cautious and consideration.
Indeed. And if you do it, and they don't seem to have the ability to uphold the standards of your people, at least do the honorable thing and take them back out of this world that you've brought them into.
There is a reason why one of our traditions is accountability and progeny. It is our responsibility for those that are young to guide them and to take accountability for their actions when they cannot. And if they never can, then to remove them and to call a blood hunt and end them.
Hopefully you never have to experience that.
I have been part of many blood hunts, my dear.
I mean from your own siring.
I am no longer a fledgling or neonate. I'm well past that time in my life. My father is no longer accountable for me. I am accountable for my own actions.
Okay. What I'm trying to say is hopefully if you ever have to turn or do turn somebody, you don't happen to have that issue.
I do not ever intend on turning anyone, so it should be fine.
I find the ones that do often don't plan on it.
As I said, there are no mortals I am particularly fond of. I'm not concerned of it. Besides, I would need permission to create progeny anyways.
Well, at least there's that.
Again, I adhere to the traditions. I am a very conservative kind. Thou shalt only sire when another with a permission of thine elder. My elder lives, so I would need my father's permission.
I wouldn't require permission myself.
You probably do not have your sire, then.
I was born.
Parent, then.
Didn't really know them, to be honest.
My point. Proven.
Though I was taken in by a pretty nice pack.
I don't know, it all seems a bit unusual to me. I don't understand it. Foreign, to say the least.
Don't understand what?
It's all pack nonsense.
Well, we're a very feral people. Hell, trying to control our own emotions is difficult on the best days. Oh, all cards on the table. I was told about you.
What were you told about me?
How you feed.
Who the fuck told you?
Another one that feeds like you do.
Who the fuck told you? Give me a fucking name.
Why is it that important?
Yes, it's that fucking important. Give me a fucking name.
Not if you talk to me like that, I won't.
Please.
Okay. It was Zardira.
And how would she know how I fucking feed?
Don't ask me.
I do not speak to Zardira infrequently, if ever, and I have never fed in front of her. So she can shove what she told you up her ass.
Hey, I'm not the one going around saying things.
Well, you can tell her to shove what she told you up her fucking ass.
So, not true, I take it?
Not her fucking business. And you can take it as not fucking true. I'm so fucking sick of people knowing things that they don't fucking know.
You know, I could take it as true by your reaction, but at the same time, I respect you enough to just say that it's not true.
What did she fucking tell you? Please enlighten me what she told you about me.
It was like a week or so ago. Just, that there's like 5 vampires, give or take, that feed on emotions in land, and you happen to be one of them.
And she happens to know things that she shouldn't, and doesn't know, in fact, so she needs to take that and shove it up her fucking ass, and stop telling people things she doesn't fucking know.
Okay.
I have spoken to him perhaps 4 or 5 times, and never about feeding. Nor have I ever fed in front of her, nor do I really feed in front of anyone.
Then I'll take it that she wasn't aware of your feeding and she's mistaken. Trust me, I do get it. A bunch of people accuse me of being a lichen of all things that I've never even fucking met. But they were told by people I've never talked to.
Yeah, I'm really not fucking okay with that.
Welcome to the club. Membership meetings are every Thursday, right after the Daylan cultist meetings. Okay, out of respect for you, I don't know anything about it, okay?
I appreciate that.
Appreciate what? I forgot what we were talking about.
Yeah, no, you're, it's, this is the thing. Anytime somebody fucking says that, you say, you give me a fucking name, or this conversation is done. Because you need to start reporting meta. You have to start reporting meta because anyway, people are really fucking bad about it, and I'm done with it.
Was that all the Lycan questions you may or may not have had?
Yeah, probably.
Okay.
My level of irritation right now is extremely high. I'm just irritated. No, no, it's not even people being everywhere all the time. It's people hearing something in a fucking stream and knowing it. Gloria's never talked to Zadaria about being a Psy. Gloria's never presented as a Psy anywhere except... unlike the three people she fucking feeds on, who keep it to their fucking self because she has fucking shit on them. And in the hospital, I don't care if it was unintentional or not, it's very fucking meta. And in the clinic, where she was treated by family and people who already fucking knew. And it's like, Gloria doesn't tell people she's a Psy. Gloria doesn't tell people she's a Psy, and she doesn't feed in front of people in a way that's recognizable. She'll hold somebody's fucking hand. You don't know what that is. You don't get to recognize what that fucking is. Even if you are a Psy, maybe you might have some inkling about it. But that doesn't mean you get to fucking share that fucking secret. And it's really, really, really fucking irritating. I've only got his word? What do you mean I've only got his word? Missouri is not intentionally meddling this. He thought it was something that she was told and she wasn't told. Which is why he said he'd back it up. Because that's... he's gotten that shit... It's coming from Zadaria, because Zadaria told him. Look at it this way, Dame. Who in Grimm would know she's a Psy? Kasha knows, because Kasha's her oldest friend and helped her understand that she was a Psy. Her uncle and her father, because she had a fucking mental break on them. Lacroix. Melodia and Tanith, but she also knows their fucking secret. Who else knows? Maybe Rel, but he's not telling anybody, and he doesn't really have necessarily proof on it. Just, she explained something about it. She never used the word Psy. Which is yours if you wish to recognize that that happened or not. Yeah, she's fed on, she has fed on Gray, right? But she feeds on a lot of people, and I have always told the people that she feeds on, it's up to you if you recognize it or not, right? But even if you recognize that she did something, that doesn't mean you know she's a Psy. Vaktu knows. Vaktu's not gonna fucking tell people. Oh, because I'm talking to people in DMs. I'm not mad at him. He's already agreed to roll this back because it was meta. Yeah. And Gloria, if you ask her about it, it'll tell her she fucking dominated you. Which isn't outside of the realm of possibility, right? She dominated you with the term calm, right? If you ask her what she did, she'll tell you. Yeah, she'll tell you she used dominate. Which is kind of what it equates to. She used command, right? The treasure chest's not counting towards the vault. I found them earlier and took them all the way back to my base and wouldn't register. You can't grash it. You can't. Oh, Lightning, I can explain. You can't drop it. You have to place it. If you don't place the treasure, it doesn't count. Yeah. No, like if people ever ask her, she'll just tell you I used the most simple effect of dominate called command. Because she always says, be calm. Right? So the immediate jump to sigh Oh, anytime she feeds, she almost always says, be calm. The only one she doesn't really do it with is Voktu, because Voktu knows she's feeding. Or she'll call it hand-holding therapy. But she is a Ventru, and she does have the ability to dominate, which she'll tell you that's what it is. Yeah, it's very, very frustrating in general for people to jump to that conclusion. I'm really sorry. Alright, we should get back to town. Or it looks like I've dragged you off into the woods to kill you.
I mean, wouldn't be the first one to attempt it to.
Could be the last, though.
Oh, there's something I have to tell you, and I'm very sorry about it.
Oh god, no. Oh god, no! The world is crappy! Everything's crappy! Alright, so what do you need to tell me?
I brought you here, I'm taking you back.
Oh god, why are you touching me? I hate it.
Is it really touching? I mean, I cover all my skin. You're just touching fabric.
I'm having a seizure.
And besides, I like to think of myself as a gentleman. I brought you out of the town, I'm bringing you back in.
Listen, I am the lady, and you are, I am the knight, and you are the princess, alright? Also, in this, this is one of the few times that I will be okay with being carried, because the world is so fucking angry. But never again. Yep.
Oh, princess, you know how to make a girl blush.
I am not a princess, and if you ever fucking call me that again, I will smash your face into the wall so it's even more ugly than it already is!
Not you. You said you're the knight and I'm the princess. And I said you know how to make a girl blush.
Okay, yes, you can be the princess.
I demand some fancy shoes.
You demand fancy shoes. Well, we should go find Maestra and she can make you fancy fucking shoes.
Okay. Now, we're near the Chair of Great Curses.
The Chair of Great Curses. Oh, Chair, please release me from all that is doom. No, you have to hold it and then it's like E. I'm really not sure I want to get involved in the Chair of Great Dooms, but, you know, you and me, Chair.
I would recommend the Bench of Gladness.
Wouldn't recommend, maybe, not involving myself with any of this, the Chair of Doom or the Bench of Gladness. You know what I should do? I should go visit the place that I know was on fire that I actively avoided visiting the other day.
Oh, what place is that?
The Archive.
Yes, I keep getting told about the Archive. I've just never been.
Hey, don't worry. It's literally always on fire, and I'm going to go check on them. So, yeah.
Well, I'm going to go back home because my brain doesn't like it here.
No, I don't know what it is going on here, but it's... I don't think it's here necessarily. I think it's just everywhere.
All right. Have fun.
You too.
Thanks for the talk.
Yeah, same. See my chickens? No, I didn't see your fucking chickens.
I'm not paying you for this. Fuck off.
That's terrifying.
Saved by the Bell. Who goes there? Oh no! Ah! I'm okay. Hello.
Oh my god, I'm just watching you fly off of the bridge.
It's okay, don't worry. I might die, but don't worry about it.
You're descending into the ether.
Don't worry about it, I'm fine.
Nope, you've just crashed into the iceberg over there.
Oh, no, I'm fine, don't worry. Here, come in.
I cannot come in because you are in the ether!
Let's just pretend that she's just...
Fine.
Next
fine.
To me in the ether.
Well, you're going into the ether too.
We're all in ether.
I know. What a bad day.
Now you're both outside and I'm inside, and this is not how I wanted the day
it's
to go.
Okay. It's okay. To the fire. To the fire.
Okay. So you're barefoot. You're barefoot.
What? It feels good on my toes. I love the snow. Don't be judging me.
I like that. How there's no doors on any buildings here. There's no, like...
You know, they'll get there. They're walking. at least you can see the drawbridge.
Yeah, that was true. This is your wellness check. Because a couple days ago, I know shit was happening, and no one... I asked, you need help? Nobody said anything, so I just went home. Then I had things later, and I was like, you know, I'm going to go home, because Tina said you were all fine. I knew for a fact that there was a frenzy in the middle of Murky Stone, and I didn't believe there were enough witnesses. And I know that Tina was coming back from here, and I believe I met the one that he went off on, actually, Mr. Lawrence.
Thank you.
Am I wrong?
Mr. Lawrence is a special individual. We didn't know he was special until it was spoken of.
Miss Lee's butler and private retained doctor, it sounds like.
Yeah. Very kind man. Funny at that. Made quite an impression on Jesse, yeah. He's coming over to meet the rest of the family.
And he decided he wanted to eat him?
Not necessarily, no. Jesse quite likes Lawrence a lot. It's just what Lawrence is that caught Jesse off guard.
Hence your wellness check. How is everyone doing?
Excuse me.
We're surviving. All we can do right now.
That does not sound good. Is it a frenzy or a break?
I'm not gonna interrupt father time any more than I already am, but can you get out with your time?
Who is whispering? That is the most ominous voice I've never heard before.
Shut the fuck up!
I felt that whisper was over my shoulder on my neck. I felt it right there.
Yeah, no, it definitely feels like there's whispering right behind us, and I can't see anyone who would be whispering, so I'm really concerned.
Do you see me?
I see Alan, yes. And
we
Leo.
Are the walls. We see
you.
No, please! For God's sake, I don't need any more whispering in the walls!
It was actually me, so that's pretty funny.
Don't you like it when God spring in here like this? There's a Becky next to you.
Hey, little cutie, let me whisper in your ear.
Tell me everything about
going to put both of you on the ground.
I would probably like that, so I'm leaving that comment there, and I'm walking away again.
Listen, you might walk away, but you're still within arm's reach of me for the next at least 2 minutes. You might think you're not, but I guarantee you I could still grab you. This is fine. Yep, no, she just walking over to the garden, backwards, slow moon dancing over there.
This is how we're walking a day.
This is the day, right? This is how it goes. Forever. And she's back.
I'm just gonna stare menacingly while I wait for everything.
I'm in danger.
See you, Gloria.
You're welcome.
What happened? Wasn't a frenzy or a break. I just feel like it was. And being caught off guard. Hard to explain. What do you call when it's you haven't had sugar in so long that you try to eat all the good things for your body? All of a sudden you come across this one delicious slice of cake. You say, oh, it's made from all flowers and grain. All of a sudden you bite into a huge chunk of sugar. Caught off guard. Guess it was kind of like that.
I saw him in Blackie's Stone. That was something.
That time, that incident that happened with Alex, you remember. You got the report.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he fed on her. Like an addiction.
Yeah. Apparently, this man, he is also like her. Now, I spoke with Alex. He said, I guess people like her, their bloods could all be different. But anytime now, if Jesse finds himself around Alex or Whisper, he keeps his guard up always to not slip up ever. Then when he had found out that Lawrence was also one of them, that guard was not up. And he wasn't himself for that moment. He didn't want to hurt him, and nor did he. Thank God the family was all around him. Alan was able to calm him down, and he came back to himself. They brought him back home. But he did not hurt him.
be called an addiction, my dear. In a certain food makes you fancy. Makes it so you cannot stop when you smell it. Those foods that drive you to drink too deeply. Leave someone a husk. A lot of us have them. Best not to sink your teeth into it at all, in my opinion.
Jesse, he's always really good at controlling himself when it comes to feet, especially if it's been a couple days. But yeah, as you said, he has never had that type of blood before until Alex. So he's been making sure he's his guard up all if he ever sees her. Or whispers.
Fucking mages.
A mage? Someone in the ether.
Huh? What?
You said mages. Is there anyone in the ether that I do not see?
No, I suppose that's just what I've always called them. The enlightened. Oh. It's what the old scriptures called them.
I never knew, though.
Mage or enlightened. They don't speak much on them in the old books, but they're there, mentioned in passing. Right next to Moonbeast. Of the enlightened, the mother of power, Dark Lilith, is one of the greatest of them, but there are others and more to come. Drink not of their blood, for they will ensnare you. Keep wary of them, for they are crafty. They know Adam's knowledge and Eve's wisdom. They are the bringers of fire, the tillers of soil, the husbanders of animals, the bringers of writing. They are sun children, the rising stars. They will seek to involve you in their journeys. Resist, resist. Their paths disregard hunger, blood, and body. Trust not the ones with bright eyes towards the dawn. Remember always, it is the dawning that brings you death. Called the enlightened in the old scriptures. Sometimes called mages or whatnot. Right in there with the nope category of things to feed on.
What do you think their purpose is?
I don't know. But they're all very strange. And they're hard to really understand what they are. I wouldn't even know of them if not mentioned in scriptures. And I didn't recognize them until I'd seen the sort of reflections in them. They're not moonbeasts, they're not kindred. They're definitely not dead, so what are they? That's the only thing left they could be. Unless they're fairies. You know, the old scriptures talk of fae too.
Damn fae.
I don't think they're fairies, so all that leaves is the enlightened, the mages. The magic ones.
It's kind of something. kind of hear about our kind and humans and werewolves and demons. They all seem to, all of us seem to have our side and where we stand. But these wizards, as you call them, don't really know what side they stand on. Seems to stand on a side I guess they are uncomfortable with at the moment.
They probably stand on whatever side gets them the most power. They are Lilith's children. It's all about power for them then.
Power.
And probably power through knowledge. It's all manner of spell work, and I don't understand any of it. You know.
You and me both, sister.
You know, the old scriptures say that the powers that we have came from Lilith. We learned from her and sought out our own. The whole chapter on it. Lilith's gift and all the things we learned from her. But, if she had her own children, these enlightened ones, I imagine they would be quite powerful. Don't let me ramble on or read scripture to you all day.
No. I find these type of parables interesting. Love to learn about this type of thing. Understand the people closely. Understand what's their true motives.
You know, people ask me a lot about the things outside of Kindred. And I can only point to the minor passages where they're mentioned. And then I go ask them about their own scriptures, and they're completely, utterly different. You know the Lycans talk about a worm?
A worm?
Like a dragon. Says that's where we come from. We're the corruptive, destructive dragons, children.
Now that, I did not hear about.
Listen, Lycans.
Is this only their belief?
Lycans have very strange stories.
They're kind of strange looking creatures. But I do like to learn of their culture and their background, I tell you that. They may not have the best smell, but they're interesting.
I know they're all. It's the same way that you might end up. Some of us believing one thing and some of us believing another, post Council of Shadows and all of that. But Reformation, where you fall in the history of it all, but they probably all have their own stories too. Have a nice night, Reaper.
So what's your story?
Oh. I was a servitor to House Blackwood. I died in service and was brought back, is the short story of it. I was given Lazarus' gift as a reward for my service.
But is that the story that you want for you?
Why wouldn't it be?
I guess it's just a thought. I just know before I became who I am, I thought I had my story all figured out. I had a path, I had a vision of what I wanted, but started to learn that it actually wasn't ever my whole vision. It was someone else's vision that they wanted for me. Started realizing what I really wanted for my story. I guess maybe that's why I look at you in a certain way. You're a strong woman. You know exactly your strengths, your weaknesses. You know the type of people you want around you. But I feel that you want something more for yourself. Of course, I don't know what that is. Only you would know.
I cannot even think of a time before House Blackwood. I was always one who served. Even before my embrace, I served. I was rewarded for my service as a sent to Squire. So, I was given a great many gifts because of my service, including Lazarus' gift, so. I had never considered anything outside of that. My father's guidance has always been perfect. He has never led me astray. And he has always accepted when I have failed and helped raise me back up.
That is perfect. Your happiness. I'm sorry.
You never questioned anything outside of duty and loyalty and honor. Never felt I needed to. Does that plague you?
It does at times. Actually, we lived for so long. I wondered what the hell really makes me happy.
Violence. That's up there on things that make me happy. It's violence.
Yeah. Yeah, just like Nimue.
Probably to the point where it puts me on the... People think I'm Bruja because of it, how much I enjoy it.
I always say, who gives a fuck what people think? As long as it makes you happy in the end.
Makes me happy and someone else is on the floor. I'll even take being on the floor sometimes. It doesn't bother me too much. As long as there's a good violence about it. It is invigorating to me.
You know, I hear that Brujas are fierce warriors. I could tell you're very, very fierce.
Not Bruja.
Mm-hmm. You don't mind me asking you. Just from watching sometimes how you fight and the joy in your eyes. Are you like me? I guess.
What do you mean, dear? I am not understanding your question.
Marcel, what is of your people?
My clan?
It is not one that needs to be hidden, I invent you. I find that violence makes the blood sing, though. It gives forth a beautiful smell. And I haven't acted as an enforcer or sheriff for centuries, so taking a great deal of pleasure in it. What do you see in the fire when you watch it? You all seem so fascinated with it, as if it's speaking to you.
Oh. I see pictures sometimes. Like moving lights. I don't know, it's hard to explain. Maybe I'm just a moth.
Now I suspect you see freedom. This. In fire, you see freedom in fire. That's terrifying. Please don't go into the fire, either of you. Fire bad, need I remind you.
Fire bad.
Fire hurts.
It does. I hate it.
Maybe that's what I like about it. It has the power to hurt or even help create in its own unique way. But it does what it pleases and doesn't ask for anyone's permission.
God, no. See, this is why I have to come have health checks to make sure you all haven't thrown yourself on a pyre.
What? The fire's beautiful. Look at it. It's honest. It's who it is. It doesn't hide itself. It knows it's dangerous. It knows it could be used for bad or good. It doesn't hide who it is.
It's a fire. It is not an animate object. It does not have thoughts and feelings. Does it tell you secrets too?
You'd be surprised.
Listen, this is why I shouldn't even fucking ask. Of course it tells you secrets. Of course it tells you secrets. For fuck's sake, no wonder this fire's here.
Come on, Gloria. You're going to pet my pet friend here, fire. I need some flame.
I do not want to pet your pet fire. I can poke it with my stick from a long ways away if that's what you really want. But I'm not petting your fire.
It likes it when you call it spark sometimes, too.
Stroke my flame, Gloria.
What about you, though, Gloria? What about your wellness check? Have you been good?
I was locked in the penthouse for 2 days because of the storm. Nothing was on fire. No one was screaming. No one was frenzied. It was quite nice. I caught up on all my reports, and then I immediately woke up, and Kasha and my uncle started arguing over something, and I was like, we've already had this argument. She won by combat. Let's leave it. I need to go visit the manor. But no, it's a very nice, long storm.
Yeah.
I cannot tell if you all are hiding something or very sad about something.
Little column A, little column B.
Listen.
Maybe a little bit of...
You didn't break the masquerade, so I'm not here to enforce any sort of punishment or anything like that.
Well, if you spank me, you better be in private.
Listen, I have definitely distributed spankings as punishments. I specifically believe it was to Alarin in public.
Oh my goodness.
She was under arrest and she tried to. I'm not going to actually say this, that's her story to tell.
Oh my goodness.
Ask her why she was arrested and spanked.
Sounds like a good story, maybe.
I mean, she probably is not going to be happy that I mentioned it.
I'll have to check on her, make sure she's alright.
Oh my.
What was that?
Other than that, us being snowed in hasn't been too bad.
Thank you.
Of course.
Really enjoy the flame that much. Michael's curse.
I mean, I don't always stand around here. I do need to check on my things.
Well, I like to
stretch my legs. Oh my goodness.
Get a damn chair.
I wouldn't stretch your legs. It's very dangerous everywhere. Going to dangerous rate off a fucking bridge.
Oh, okay. Alright. Well. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. Miss Gloria, I'm so sorry. It's how rude of me. Can I offer you some wine?
No, I'm alright, dear. Listen, I had a cask of wine in my penthouse. I was quite pleased with myself. I might have still been in it tonight, actually.
We can go in the library, at least. Or, I don't know.
Whatever, I didn't mind. I didn't know where that is, but alright.
Yeah, have you not been in the library?
Vim.
I feel like every time Gloria comes over,
it's either by the gate or the fire.
Yeah,
pretty much. I got a tour, though, the one day. I thought there was a knife on the table. Yes, you brought my father in here to sign documents, and then I buggered off. Did all of your books go poof?
Oh yeah, then Jesse started flirting with him. Yes, I remember.
Yeah, looks like all your books went poof, I'm sorry. What is thaumaturgy?
They may have slipped through the cracks of the floorboard.
No, it's still here. Oh shit.
Well, one is.
Or the placed books, I see. Oh! Look! Murderer poems! Fun! I love it! With a picture of Mr. Forteau! That was not a book I wanted to read! Although,
we'd like to keep records. Okay, we'd like to keep records.
Alright, it's fine. No, that's fine.
We need to try to get our other books back here. They must have fell somewhere. I know Roderick is gonna be pissed.
I hope you wrote it down somewhere first.
I hope he made extra copies. I really do.
Listen, this is why I write everything into a file first, and then I make copies.
Oh, this book was blank before, but this one is still has its stuff, so it should be fine. It's fine.
See, that one's still there.
I don't know if it's only the books that have been placed down or not.
That's what I was. It seemed like it's only been the ones placed down. Yeah, it must have been the ones placed
down. I have to go check my room. Hold on.
There was a couple other books that were here, but.
All of my books burned. I will be perfectly happy to never read a thing about Jason Wardo again. Perfectly content.
Well, here, look. And now we have it here in the archives. You can look back and read on if you ever like.
Yep, I'm good, thanks.
Seems the rest of the family is still sleeping at the moment. I feel like we've been hibernating for too long.
Yes, I'm sure. You're all going in and out, definitely sleeping. definitely not hiding anything from Gloria, because if Gloria hears about it, something bad will probably happen, because then something, like, you have a fucking human tied up in a wood shop somewhere, and you're feeding on viciously or something.
Oh, we are not that barbaric.
Oh.
And you know, if we got a snack, we'll finish it right then and there. Besides, I get very hungry. I wish the rest of the family was awake, Gloria. See you.
I know, that's alright. I will probably come by tomorrow. I'll come get you all for a walk. Are you capable of going out for a walk? Have you sorted yourselves all out?
I think so.
Yeah, a walk would be nice. I really feel like an old granny when you say that.
Alright, everyone, we're going outside. Time to go social.
I don't want to stay indoors and drink my coffee.
What? Oh my god.
I need to check on my wolves, okay?
Your wolves?
My wolfies.
Oh, you know, Nimue, you just reminded me. Speaking of...
The guard ducks.
Well, we now join Grimwood, so... Your pets, they won't listen to you now, right?
No, that should have been taken care of.
All the pets were transferred to.
Oh, thank you.
They were transferred.
Listen, my father knows how to work magic with keys. He just stole everybody's keys, kicked you all out, then transferred everything all at once. It's fine.
Oh, thank goodness.
Yep.
There's one of them damn wolves down there, and then when he tried to attack me, I almost put him down.
Oh, If he attacks you and protecting yourself, I guess.
Were those sounds? Check. Were those words?
Yes.
They were something.
No.
Definitely something.
If it attacks you, let me know.
Listen.
Damn things scare me.
I'm sorry, I did make a corrupted wolf, and he's very scary looking, and I haven't trained him at all, and he's probably pretty bitey, and he has a big one.
Nimue, when are you going to let out your new pet, Charlie?
Charlie?
What's his name?
She was Charlie.
His name is Charlie. He was a gift to us, and... I wanted, you know, me and Jesse to give it to
one,
you.
I'm a little scared of that one. I don't know how that one is going to react to people.
Oh, just, you know, you just gotta give him a couple of pets and little rubs, and he'll be very nice to people. He's a sweetheart, I promise. Laura, I can't wait for you to see this new pet that she got. I swear. It's so cute.
We have to probably figure out when we're voting. Because I think the whole vote thing got fucked. Did you all submit your nominations?
I think as I got was getting a voter number.
Did you get your voter number? Is that a yes or no? Maybe?
Yes. Sorry.
Apparently. As I was talking to... Lord Grey about how the whole thing is going to go. I'm like, okay, so do the houses nominate their nominee, or is it just like the first past the post per house? And he's like, I don't know. So this will be fun. Because you've all decided to vote one way doesn't mean everybody else has decided to vote one way on who they're electing from your house.
Well, I didn't get a chance to vote.
It's very simply to first past the post. Because there's five... Or what have you, or four?
It's four elected,
I don't know,
right?
I had too much wine that night and could not follow.
It's four, right? There's four people, so you go and you put four names on the list, which you should vote for my father, because I don't want it. And that is what my father's dictated, so that is what I will tell you, although my uncle will argue about it. You all decided on Alarin?
Who was running to be in a council seat. Who were all running?
I nominated Seb, so I think that would be hilarious. he's going to hate it. Alarin and Lillian both can rerun. I imagine maybe one of the Volkovs will run, but we won't know the nominations until we go check. We could go poke poor little Grey, like, hey, who got nominated? Well, the nominations are not done either, right? Because they were supposed to be, but then we had the storm, and, you know, it's fine. Maybe we'll do, like, a little science festival thing tomorrow.
Oh, science!
Well, so it was supposed to be on Friday, right? But then everything went to shit, and that didn't happen.
Oh. I'm guessing I wanted to postpone it for another day.
Yeah, so maybe we'll do that tomorrow or something like that. Honestly, I just take cover. I'm assuming tomorrow everything's going to fucking explode. It'll be a nice quiet night. Right? Right?
Yes. Yes. Right. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I'm
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Listen, I am sensing an extreme amount of lying, but that's fine because it's not my problem until you tell me it's my problem or you break the masquerade, then I don't have to fucking care.
No. It's all good.
Listen, there was nothing quite as sussy as, like, Alarin. I think it was Alarin on that day just been like, It's fine! Tina Lee collecting Lauren's from the tea shop at 4 o'clock in the morning going, It's fine! And I was like, alright, nobody's gonna tell me it's fine that I don't have to report it until someone died. Someone died, then I have to care.
No, it died. I think. Yep, no one died.
Yep. No, I mean, no. Yeah.
I died.
No one died.
That's extremely suspicious the way you just said that. Listen, we've covered up one murder. We could cover up another. Actually, I think I've covered up two or three, actually. At this point, it's fine.
Look, I've been drinking wine this whole time. Don't listen to anything I'm saying right now.
I had a case of wine, me and that penthouse, me and the case of wine in the penthouse. It's fine, too. So...
yeah. I still didn't finish mine. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to finish it now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look, there's a moon.
Oh, look, there's a sky.
Oh, look! The moon beasts are out and howling. Ooh, dumb dogs. Ooh.
Damn dogs. It is beautiful, that one.
Nimue just bringing the violence.
Nimue, you better stop before your father thinks that you're part wolf.
I'm concerned, actually. You know, it's fine. Maybe I should go to bed so I can get up early and then harass people tomorrow. It'd be fine.
Mm-hmm. You should come harass us first.
First? I don't know. If I come here first, I'll miss all of the explosives, which I'm not sure if I want to or not, because I feel like all of you start burning later in the evening.
Oh, no. Come early. You'd be around early, too, and if you come early, you have breakfast with us.
Bring the flatbread. I will get my father and my uncle and maybe Kash if she's not mad at me. I'm not sure if she's mad at me or not. And we'll bring the Blackwoods. And definitely nothing will go wrong because it's, you know, your constabulary is here to take care of everything that's gone wrong. It's fine.
Oh, I think that would be lovely. We could have like a family bruncheon. What do you think, Nimue?
The last time I planned tea with anyone from this household... I frenzied. I'm pretty sure Jesse went off the deep end on something. It was not a great day for anyone.
It was quite a busy day. The schedule was full and it was packed. Okay.
Everyone forgot about tea. It was great. It's fine. Nobody fucking cares about tea. I'm gonna get back to the manor, I think.
And let's reschedule. Let's do brunch and stay with our family.
We'll do brunch, right. Yep. and I'm just glad that, you know, the last time I had family dinner, I didn't have to deal with, like, a lockcart in my fucking house. It was great. All I had to deal with was my family attempting to stab each other, which is a perfectly normal, reasonable way to deal with conflict.
That's the best way to deal with
it. Yes. Do you think I can get home without the world exploding in my face? Because I think I should.
You've got a 50-50 chance there, I think.
Got a 50-50 chance. Alright, I'm going to meander then. Definitely going to slowly walk towards the door.
Yeah, just slowly walk, or if when you get to the drawbridge, maybe just jump, and maybe you'll just, like, ether your way home.
Just jump. Alright, that seems safe.
Maybe you'll glide all the way home.
Game for the water. Alright, definitely.
Game for the water.
So this is how Gloria dies. It's fine.
Doesn't
ask no. Yep. I survived. Yay.
You survived.
Yay. You know, you put this here and now I can't go through and it makes me sad.
Oh.
Because this is the way I go home. But that's fine. I'll just go around. Have a nice night.
You too.
Alright, yeah, we're gonna go to bed. Yeah. Yep. I don't think it matters, and I think I'm just gonna do the slash home. Because it's very late, and I'm gonna go to bed. I was gonna be like, the manor is missing. Oh, great. The door is missing. Alright, guys. I will see you tomorrow. I don't think there's anyone to raid because nobody else came online like an idiot like at 5 a.m. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye!